Scientists, for many years, have been struggling to make the nano building blocks of life. These are tiny little building blocks at the nanoscale. Today, I'd like to present to you the next generation of factories that will make these building blocks. We call them plants. But first, let's talk about our needs. We use many medical devices, many medical implants in our body. They are made of synthetic materials, which we screw and we glue into our body. Well, that may not be such a great idea. Why? Because they fail. In nature, materials are built differently. There is no one there to screw my head into my neck or to glue my skin onto my body. In nature, materials are self-assembled. Every living cell has a DNA that encodes for the building blocks. And these building blocks recognize each other and self-assemble into scaffolds together with cells that grow tissues, that grow organs, that brings life. We at the Hebrew University, about 10 years ago, decided to focus on probably the most important bio-building blocks for human, collagen. Collagen accounts for about 25% of our dry weight. Bone, for example, 50% collagen, 50% mineral. Tendons and ligaments, close to 100% collagen. So I'd say that anyone who is in the business of replacement parts for human being would need collagen. And in fact, even before we started, about 10 years ago, there have been already more than 1,000 medical devices that are made of collagen. For example, artificial meniscus, bone grafts, and even heart valves. So where is the problem? Well, the problem is that all that collagen is extracted from dead bodies. Pigs, cattle, and even human cadaver. So safety is a big issue, but not the only one. In fact, the collagen that is extracted from dead tissue is partially defected and therefore do not perform as a brand new one. And the FDA actually made a notice in 2007 asking the companies to start and look for better alternatives. And there are alternatives. For example, insulin, which is a recombinant protein. So people clone the insulin gene from human, introduce it into yeast, which we use to ferment wine or beer. And now we can extract from the fermentation broth the insulin, purify it, and give it to needed diabetic patients. So why not do the same with collagen? Well, collagen is much more difficult. And the reason is that unlike insulin, which is simple, it's a single gene that encodes for a single protein. To make collagen, it requires the concerted effort of 5 human genes. And about 10 years ago, when we started the project, the idea is that one will take 5 human genes and introduce them into a single host would be unimaginable. We thought differently. We decided to take advantage of plants. Plants have this beautiful phenomenon that you can actually clone lesser amount of genes in one plant, take the other set of genes, and clone them into the other plants, and then simply take the pollen of one and put it on the flower of the other and cross them, and now you have a hybrid seed. And that hybrid seed now contains all the 5 human genes. So that's exactly what we did. It took us about 1 year with numerous of experiments, but at the end of the year, we have been able to detect tiny little amount of collagen, human collagen, in transgenic tobacco plant. Today, 10 years later, in Israel, my company CoPlant has 25,000 square meters of greenhouses all over Israel, from the north to the south, where the farmers receive the tobacco plants, which are really tiny, that looks exactly like regular tobacco, except that they contain all the 5 human genes that are necessary to make the collagen. Between 4 to 6 weeks later, they harvest the leaves. The leaves are then transported by cooling trucks to the factory in the north. Actually, making collagen from these leaves looks like making pesto. Except that we take the juice, and from that juice, we extract the collagen. We purify it in clean rooms from which we make the different medical devices. One medical device, for example, is a bone void filler. This material contains 100% collagen, pure collagen, identical to the human, extracted from the plant, together with hydroxyapatite ceramics. So it feels actually like Play-Doh. And the surgeon can take this material and shape it and sculpture it and put it in the void where there is a missing bone. Now, the cells in the bone marrow recognize the collagen and they attach to it. And once they attach to it, they start to proliferate and they grow. And in a few weeks, they make a brand new bone. Well, nature didn't stop there. 3.5 billion years of evolution resulted in some remarkable, remarkable materials. The one that really attracted my personal attention is a protein building block, which is called resilin. Resilin is probably the most elastic material on Earth. In simple words, it's the best rubber. And cat fleas take this beautiful phenomenon of resilin that enable them to jump as high as 200 times their height. This is the equivalence of a person standing in the middle of Manhattan and in a single jump go to the top of the Empire State Building. That's amazing. And even safely land. So it will be wonderful if we could have that material. I mean, I could think of lots of good things that I can do with that. Well, there is one big problem. Catching cat fleas is difficult because they're jumpy. And even if you caught few, they don't have much resilin. It's very little. But if you caught one, now you can extract its DNA and clone it into a much more friendly organism, tobacco plant. And that's exactly what we did. And now we can produce that collagen, that resilin in the tobacco plant. So now imagine, what would happen if you have collagen and you mix it with a little bit of resilin? Well, that's what happened. We've been able to make a super tendon that is actually 3 times stronger and more elastic than normal tendon. So oddly enough, a person that will be transplanted with this tendon will have a better performance than before its injury. So this is great. So what's for the future? Well, 3D printing is an existing technology. Scientists all over the world are using today 3D printers with biological materials to print 3D structures and even organs. We propose that tobacco plants may be the next generation of the factories that will produce the different building blocks. These different building blocks will be fed into the cartridges. So that will be the bio-inks that will be installed in the 3D printers to print scaffolds on which cells will grow, that make the tissues, to grow the organs, to give life to needed patients. But we don't stop there. Today, we actually grow plants. We grow plants, we feed the plants to the animals, then we slaughter the animals to make the meat. I propose that in the future, we will grow the plants that will directly feed the printers with the building blocks to make the meat for us, which will be more safe and more sustainable. Thank you.